Hello, my name is Johanna Velasquez. I'm a physical therapist assistant student here at Miami-Dade College, and today I'm going to be performing a measurement of the range of motion of the abduction of the shoulder. According to the AAOS, the normal range of motion of the abduction is 180 degrees. Hello.
Hello.
My name is Johanna. I'm going to be a physical therapist assistant today. Today I'm going to be making the measurement of the range of motion of this action. So you're going to be moving your arm away from the body to see if you have any kind of firmness. Huh?
Okay.
I need you to lay down, face up. First, I'm going to place my patient in the testing position. Then I'm going to move the patient through the available range of motion. Determine the end fear, which is firm, and make a visual estimate of the range of motion, which is 180 degrees. I'm going to return the patient to the starting position. I'm going to palpate the anatomical landmark, which is going to be the anterior aspect of the acromion process, where my fulcrum is going to go. The proximal arm is going to be parallel to the midline of the anterior aspect of the sternum, and the distal arm is going to be anterior midline of the humerus. I'm going to be using the middle epicondyle of the humeral as a point of reference. I'm going to align the goniometer with my anatomical landmark, read and record the range of motion of the starting position, which is zero. I'm going to remove the goniometer, perform a passive range of motion, replace the goniometer, and align with the anatomical landmark, read and record the range of motion of the ending position, which is 180 degrees. And this is how you measure the range of motion of the abduction of the shoulder. Thank you.